Hello friends, how are you? Hope you're fine and doing good. So how was your CSM preparation? I believe it must be going awesome. Everything will be on track. You must be meeting all your goals. You must be achieving all your specific goals for per day or for a week. I mean, have you started creating the milestones for your daily task or at least for week? If not, you can start. I have created a separate video for strategy and planning. You can just have a look of that video, and that will help you to create the CSM plan. If you have any queries, any question, you can WhatsApp me. You can see this is my WhatsApp number 9619094404, and you can also mail me on my email ID, which is help@visionandgoal.com. Mind you, friend, there is one more N, right? So there is a 2N here. So you can mail me, you can WhatsApp me, and I will try to help solving your questions or queries, right? So let me start the video. The very first point which we'll be covering as a part of the CSM preparation series is from the very first domain, which is information security governance, right? So this is the paid video for those students who have not subscribed yet. They will be getting some part of the video, because for the paid subscriber, I will be sharing this video the complete length, right? Otherwise it will be available for a small length of the video, right? You can contact me for the paid subscription, right? There are certain benefits also, but before that, let me tell you what are the things we'll be covering as a part of introduction for today's video. We'll be covering the understanding of information security governance. What's the meaning of governance specifically? What is the meaning of security policy? What is the security policy? In fact, what is a policy, right? We also understand the meaning of a standard, the meaning of business cases, right? Other than this, we'll also touch information security program, senior management prospect view, and others, right? So these are the some high level things which we'll be covering in today's session, right? Now let me tell you what are the benefits if somebody has paid for this CISM preparation series. So the benefit number one is, first of all, I will be explaining the detailed explanation of CISM review manual from the recommended book of ISACA, which is CISM review manual 15th edition. That is the recommended book by ISACA. If you want to crack the CISM exam, this book is something which you have to have, right? How to study, what to study, what's the plan, that I'm going to explain you also as my second benefit, that I will support you in making the strategy. I have already created a video, as I mentioned few moments back. So I will also help you in making the strategy and plan, and that too based on your convenience, based on your availability, right? I will also discuss with you in person, that too on call. I'm not saying by writing text. No, you can call me twice in a month on my WhatsApp number. I have already shared my WhatsApp number, that is +91, that's India prefix, and then 9619094404. So using that, you can call me twice in a month, and that is only for the paid subscriber, right? So that's the benefit number three. The fourth benefit is in-depth explanation of mock questions. I am saying in-depth explanation. That means I will be explaining the options. Why, let's say, A is correct and why B, C or D is not correct. The reason being why these things is not correct, what the thought process we should develop, right? So I will help you to develop that thought process, plus what are the things you should not supposed to think when solving any questions, right? So these are certain things which I will be helping you to understand the question while explaining in depth analysis of those questions, right? So that's the benefit number four. The fifth benefit is the most crucial, I would say, from above all four. The fourth benefit is itself is one of the very important thing, but I personally believe the fifth one is the most crucial. I'm telling you why. Because if you are very good in 1, 2, 3 and 4, even then if the fifth is not work for you, then again there will be a challenge that you need to work it out. So the fifth point is I will help you to study. I will help you to make a strategy for the final week of your exam. I will share certain tips with you. I will share what to do and what not to do. That is very important. In fact, I would say what not to do is very important during your final exam. During your final week of exam, right? So this is very important, what not to do, right? So this is the five benefit. If I'm saying in a nutshell, there must be some more benefits which you got to know as soon as we move forward, right? So this is the certain points which I want to share for the paid subscriber. Now friends, you want to see my all CISM preparation videos that I have already mentioned. I have already uploaded on video, but you can I have already uploaded on YouTube, but you can also find on my this URL which I am highlighting now, which is tinyurl.com/CISM preparation. Let me just move my image aside just a second. Yeah, so you can just need to go, so you require to go to tinyurl.com/CISM preparation, and there you can find my all videos what I prepared so far for CISM preparation, right? So this is all about some benefits. So let's get started with our first topic, which is CISM Prep Series Domain 1, Information Security Governance, right? So we'll start with the introduction part. So friends, for the information security to effectively address, for nowadays we'll be having ever growing challenges of providing the adequate protection of assets, right? So we require to have a adequate protection of information assets. So how do we do that? So for that, an information security strategy is utmost important. It is essential. And what is this strategy is all about? This strategy is a document. This strategy is a document, and this document gives the direction and goal for the information security program. So this will give the direction and goal for the information security program, right? Now who gives this direction, who gives this goal? This is been determined by the senior management. Senior management determined the direction and goal for the information security program. Now subsequently, the strategy also provide the baseline for or to implement the effective information security governance, right? So this strategy, whatever we have just learned, this is going to be give a baseline for the information security governance. So you need to understand that for information asset, we must have to have the information security strategy in place, and that is nothing but a document. The document gives the direction and goal and for the information security program, and which is been determined by the senior management, and on a whole, this strategy, this information security program, direction, goals, this will give the baseline for the information security governance, right? This is what we have just learned. Now, what is governance? See, point number two, governance is broadly defined as a rule. Rule of what? Rules who run the organization. Run the organization, right? And these include policies, standard and procedure, right? And these policies, standard and procedure are used to set the direction. This will give the direction and control of what? Of organization activity, right? So this policy, standard and procedure gives the direction and control of the organization activities, right? Now, the very first step or the very first thing in establishing the information security governance is senior management who determine the outcome, right? So senior management is determine the outcome. Outcome from where? From the information security program. For example, let's say you are information security manager and you are proposing a information security program, but the outcome is based on the determination of the senior management, right? Now, how do you decide the outcome will be what, right? In fact, you means here, let's say a joint coordination between you, senior management, and the business head, business unit head, right? So the often these outcomes are stated in terms of two ways. First is risk management, and another one is the level of acceptable risk, right? Outcome is based on these two things. First is risk management, and based on the second thing is what will be the acceptable risk level for that organization, right? So far so good. Let me know if you have any doubt in the comment section, right? Now, this can be accomplished through the set of facilitated meeting with the senior management and business unit head. Just now I explained, to know the outcome, to know the risk management, to know the level, you have to have multiple meetings with the business unit head and the senior management, right? Now, the information security manager then has a good information. Good information for what? For having to develop a set of requirement based on his meetings. I don't know how to erase it. Just a second. Let me try to erase first. Pointer eraser. Yeah. And then pointer pen. Yeah. So, sorry, highlighter. My bad. Pointer and filter. So, based on the data, based on the information what he received while having a multiple meeting with the senior management and business unit leader, he require or he make a document which contains the set of requirement, right? For the security program, right? And this is followed by the series of specific objective, and when achieved, we'll say our requirement is satisfied, right? So an element of developing the strategy is to develop objective. When we say objective, we are talking about the desired state, right? What management is actually looking for, right? So that comes under our desired state, right? That's the first thing. Then the desired state is based on the outcome set by the senior management, and a variety of frameworks nowadays are available through which you can make a desired outcome or the desired state. This outcome and the level of acceptable risk should be determined and used to set the control objective. After that, the information security manager can determine what need to be done to move from the current state to the desired state, right? So I'm talking about the roadmap here. This is the roadmap where you know the current state, you know the desired state, and you need to create a road through which you can pass from current state to desired state, right? For that, you need to do one very important thing, what we called as a gap analysis, right? From the current state to desired state, you need to do a gap analysis, right? Now, this roadmap is created to identify the specific need to achieve the objective. Friends, I just mentioned the specific need. Need is something which is one of the keyword you have to have in your mind when you are talking about the objective of any information security program. If need is not there, whatever you are doing is not going to work for that information security governance or for the solution whatever you are giving to the organization. So need is very important to understand why certain solution or the information security program itself is needed. That should be very clear without any ambiguity, right? So information security governance need to be integrated to the overall enterprise governance structure. Why? Because this will ensure that the organization's goals are supported by the information security program, right? So integration is very important. The governance framework is an outline or the skeletal of interlinked item that supports a particular approach to a specific objective, as we have discussed in the strategy. Now, the information security governance is a subset of corporate governance. So you have to have understanding that whatever you are doing is basically a subset of a corporate governance. That's why your integration, your awareness, you have to convince the corporate people also when you are working on the information security governance, and must be consistent with the enterprise governance, right? So that's for our slide number first. Now the next point is, what do you understand by the term security policy? So friends, security policies are designed to mitigate risk and are usually developed in response to an actual or perceived threat, right? And policy state management intent and direction at high level. So the policy, if I say, it represent or it showcase the management intent, what management is actually looking for, and direction. The keyword here is intent and direction, and that too at high level, right? So that's the meaning of security policy. Policies could be, let's say, if somebody is saying in an organization or there is a policy, that policy is safety first, right? So this is the management intent, and that too at a high level. So this is the very small policy. Policy is property of policy is this should be small, easy to understand to everyone, right? Now, with the development of information security strategy, the policy have to be developed or modified to support the strategic objective, right? So this is all about the policy. Now coming to the standard. So basically standards are what? Standards are developed to modify, to set the boundaries. Boundaries means what? Some kind of a restriction or some kind of a scope. For whom? For people. People are the most critical factor when we are doing the risk management, right? There are certain reasons which we got to know when we are doing our chapter number 2, risk, right? So people are very crucial. So people, process, procedure and technology to maintain the compliance with policies and support the achievement of the organization goals and objectives, right? So there are, so this is all about the standards. Standards are basically developed to set the boundaries. There are usually several standards for each policies, depend on the classification level of that asset related to that standards. So we have a policy that contains multiple standards, right? And that too depends upon the asset classification, right? For example, if asset is classified as a very sensitive, we could have multiple standard. So this is about standard. And now coming to the business case. Business case is used to capture the business reasoning for initiating a project or risk. While creating the business case, you have to know that why this business case is going to helpful for that organization, and it should consciously identify the need and the business purpose for implementing various governance processes. And this include technology and cost benefit. This benefit could be a tangible, this benefit could be a supportable or relevant to the organization. Here you need to put a particular attention on the financial aspect of the proposal. Friends, here finance is utmost important, right? So when you are writing any business case, you have to consider it should be tangible. You can measure if it's going to be a profit or loss, and moreover, financial aspect is the most critical. Why? Because the total cost of ownership, TCO what we called, and the risk must be relatively represented for the full life cycle of the project. In complete life cycle, you have to explain the total cost of ownership and the risk in that project. And it is very important to avoid overconfidence, over optimistic projection, right? So the strategy should keep in mind that the information security is never strategic. There are certain factors we should always include or we should always consider. Let's say we have internal factors that include changing the technologies, personal, business activities and financial capacity to absorb loss. If I'm talking about the external factors, this includes changing market, emerging threat, new technologies, increasing sophistication of attacker and new regulations. Risk and impact assessment are often a good indicator of change that may need to be made to a strategy element. So friends, this is all about our first video. In our next video, we'll move further on this chapter. Till then, let me know if you have any questions, queries, or if you want me to explain anything further. Right? Till then, bye bye, take care and stay healthy.